So now let's go to page 2. Alright, when we are gonna create the actual driving lock, you will notice that something has been generated after we input the pile depth. I'm sorry, the pile length. A table will be generated. Alright, in this particular case, we went up to under 11, which is pretty much when the where the pile is going to end up. You know, rounding up, the pile is going to end at 111 below template. Okay. Now, this would be true if when we set up the pile, there's no pre-drilling at all, and the pile at the template is right at zero, but very likely that's not going to happen. For example, you will have, if you have performed our pre-drill, like in this particular case, we pre-drill minus to minus 10, very likely when we set up the pile, we're going to be at the template maybe, who knows, let's say 20 feet. When the pile is set up, we're going to be seeing in the template 20 feet. So you notice that after I input 20, this is going to be generated automatically from 20 feet down. You notice some colors here. This blue color means this is the depth below template at which we reach minimum tip. You can tell that, for example, for the minimum tip of minus 40, you need to go, say, strictly speaking, you need to go to, say, 51.4, but somewhere in between, but we are rounding up, okay? Now, if you want to be exact and want to use partial footage, you will tell here whether you want partial footage, you know, where you want to be strict about it. So here is, you get 51.4. The only thing is, with this approach, then you will have to split up that foot, and you will count partial foot blows here, and then blows from 51.4 there. Typically, this is not done. And typically, you know, anyway, we will fill up with, you know, round foot, with whole feet. But, you know, but the capabilities are there to be strictly accurate, showing partial foot. The same happens with the set check target. Say you want to be partial, you will have this one. At 109.4, you will be 1 foot from the cutoff, and you want to see at the cutoff, at the cutoff elevation, you will be at 110.4. And again, let's put the minimum tip, so it would look like this. By the way, you will see some shading. It's gonna tell you that this is being in this particular case, you're being computed based on partial footage, you're being very accurate. Let's say, you know, but typically what I have seen is we don't need to do this, and it's gonna be enough. We just put integer numbers here, full numbers. Okay, again, so the blue is going to indicate when you will be meeting the minimum tip. The yellow is when you're going to be, you know, at set check range. So, and then this one's just going to be basically at cutoff elevation. Very likely, for the set check, it would be, I would agree that maybe at the set check may be convenient to do the partial foot, just in case, to make sure where you have the footage, where you have the actual, where will you have 1 foot left of path. Okay. What else should we tell you here? Okay, so notice something here. We got this green assistant table. Right now it's telling you that you haven't started driven yet, because the reason is because you haven't input any blows here. The moment I input any blow here, immediately change. Okay. So let's say we started with one, and maybe I got a very little stroke, maybe two, very little stroke. We can put a note here, like, you know, power was pretty much kind of running, and then then maybe here nothing. It was very soft, and maybe here I started counting some blows. Okay. Of course, gonna be here. We're gonna input. Okay, we started with setting fuel one. Okay. Then I want you to notice another thing. Every time I advance, this tip elevation keeps going deeper. And this is counting the total blows I have so far. See, for example, 30, 33. This is going to be a very useful tool if I have to be checking for changing the cushion every 1500 blows. So let's say, for example, I started having, you know, let's say I started having a lot of blows, and the 50, and the 20 is kind of. Very likely I'm gonna have here a 6 feet stroke. I'm sorry, 6 feet stroke. Maybe here I got seven, maybe here eight. Becoming maybe here I got a maybe got fuel setting two. I started using fuel setting two, maybe here I started using fuel setting three. Whatever, then I start having 8.5. Instead of using the fuel setting 4, anyway, okay, and so forth. I'm just gonna input from now on blows. All right, so let's say if I can input blows, right now I better pay attention. I'm getting close to that one. Right after here, I better change the cushion. Right here, I need to change the cushion. Okay, for this particular case. So this is the usefulness of this table, in addition, is checking every time I go, I'm checking the minimum tip as my driving goes. Alright. Let's fill more stuff here because I need to keep driving until I get my my minimum tip. I'm gonna. Oops, made a mistake. Okay. Let's say I kept driving, and somewhere here, oh shit, 72. At this moment, the contractor decided I need to change the template, or he's got a double template, so he had to remove the upper, and we were using the upper template as a reference, so we're gonna have to change the template. So, well, for some reason we had to change the template anyway. So at this point, we're gonna have to go here. The reference input. Let's say the new template elevation was a couple of feet down, just to visualize what the spreadsheet is doing. So it's basically 2 feet down. Okay. In other words, I have changed my template. My template originally was 11.4, now it's 9.4. Okay, so I'm gonna type here 2. Let's see the effect. Okay, so here I was coming with 55, now 55 becomes 53. Make sense? So we're gonna, by the way, there's an additional auxiliary table here that helps you determine whether you are in the ballpark. For example, let's say the contractor tells you originally was 11.4 and afterwards my reference elevation was 9.4 and my elevation with my original at that point was the penetration was 55 feet below the reference. So my future depth below temperature should be 53 after I change the reference. So I should be reading around 53. Doesn't have to be exact, but you know, plus or minus a couple of inches, you know, it should be okay. But you know, thing is, this is gonna help you to be to help you to make sure that you are within the right in the right value, and your changes and your readings make sense. Okay, same happens. You can check something else. For example, I could tell, okay, my depth before the change was 55. My penetration ball after the change became 53. My reference was 11.4, so my future reference should be. So it's gonna tell you. So it's kind of these tables help me understand and verify that what I'm reading makes sense. Otherwise, if I'm reading something way off, like after the change, I see my template was reading 54. I need to verify what's going on. Or even 55.5, what happened? Why do I have 6 inches difference? So, okay. All right, or if I now it's 10 of 53, I'm reading 54 and a half, 53 and a half, 50, you know. But, so you are around 53, you know, 53.1, that's fine, 50, you know, not a big deal. Or 52.9, you know, you can practically call it 53, right? So then, after the while, after that, my table gets computer. Now, this is very important that this, whatever I have done, this is in real time. I cannot go back and redo these changes later on. It's going to be tough. These changes of reference are being computed as per the latest reference. So, if you later on find out that you made a mistake here, you know, like you changed here, oh, it wasn't 20, it was 21, you know, you're going to have to type the whole thing again. So you better be careful what you input here, and you know, for because if let's say for example you type 21, this is incorrect. So it's not gonna carry over the change of the reference correctly. All right. So this is, let's come back. This is supposed to be done correctly, so that you better verify the first readings correctly and go from there. So you keep driving, 75, 77. And I'm not running this stroke. So let's say, I'm just gonna write it here. So to this point, when I was at 59, I'm gonna change again my reference. So I need to go again here. The contractor pulled it again and changed the reference. And now is 8 feet. My elevation is plus 8. So which means my reference had dropped 1.4 feet, right? So let us input, and when I go there, I go back here and type 3, see what happened, there you go. So the spreadsheet is computing 57.6, so let me see what happens here. So if I have 59, and the LP after change was 57.6, my previous reference elevation was 9.4, there you go, my new one should be 8, or I can check using this one too. Okay, that's pretty much how the computer or the spreadsheet handles this spreadsheet changes, its reference changes, okay? Now, one thing before I forget, here in this stroke, if we were using diesel hammers, that we will compute stroke. If we were using air hammers, okay, we need to check the blows per minute. Alrighty, let's check blows per minute. So we're going to be checking maybe, you know, 48, whatever, 47, because that's what is important for us, the performance of the hammer will be given. So we'll be checking stuff like this. We'll be checking blows per minute. Now, we will put a note here somewhere Let's say, for example, we start with node. Instead of fuel setting 1, we will not have fuel setting. In air handlers, we will have mostly short stroke and full stroke. We will say, for example, in node 1, we will input a node like, you know, star driving with short stroke equals 2 feet. Okay? Node 2, we could say full stroke 5 feet. Let's say that, you know, the full stroke was 5 feet. And we will put that node 2 whenever it is applicable. Let's say we put it somewhere here. Okay? So we know that then that means that we have short stroke all the way here and full stroke from this point down. Okay? That's how we will handle, you know, air hammer, diesel hammer. That's because, you know, this input could be the blows per minute pressure. If we have closed end diesel hammers, then you would input a chamber pressure, whatever the chamber pressure is. You may have a criteria based on chamber pressure, on blows per foot. So those are the three issues here. Hydraulic hammers, then you will use the equivalent stroke in hydraulic hammers. What else we need to say here? The notes, of course, we do have an explanation here of how, what notes are we using. And it's a summary that we have explained before. The other thing is at the bottom here, we have an auxiliary computation that tells you if you need to mark 2 inches, that would be equals to 0.17 feet. Inches here have to be marked on fractions of a foot. Okay, let's say for example we have to do a set check here, and the set check is, say we need to do 2 inches. We did 2 inches set check here. Okay, we're checking for, let's say, or we were verifying for refusal. Let's put something more realistic. Let's say we got 190 blows, and then so we start to verify for refusal. So we're gonna do maybe two inches. So we're gonna do 1 inch was 0.08, so we're gonna do 0.08 first. We have two ways to do that. Or we say 61.08, or just wait. Okay, so it's gonna give you 60 to 6108 and then 6108 to 62. Or we can just say equals 60 plus 1 divided by 12. You see how? Okay. We're gonna do it like that. So we can just input in a way, in a formula way, okay, by inputting equal. So let's say we did a sec check here, 60 to 6008. Now let's say, and then we do an, so we did, for example, one sec check, and then we did 19 blows per inch, AF stroke, no quarter, but then we did another one. So let's say we did another inch, so it would be 60. So we need to write type equal 60 plus 2 divided by 12. So it's gonna mark, it's gonna take some time, 60.17. Or we're gonna use how much is 2 inches here, that 0.17. So, but anyway, this is the way to indicate inches. We're going to say 60 to 60.08 feet. We cannot do 60 to 60 feet, 1 inch, or no, we have to do it this way, in fractions of 1 inch. So let's say we did 22, and then maybe stroke, and we finish. So this is, so we would put something here like, you know, we got practical refusal. I think we got a node that's called for practical refusal. We could even say, for example, pile accepted. Node number 3 would be pile accepted. Maybe it's going to be PR, something like that. Or, There is something here, you know, you see the table has been created, generated based on the original pile length that I gave of 100 feet. The pile, I can extend that table for any reason. I can extend it, you know, in preparation for splices, anything. I can ask him to extend the table, for example, 10 feet. Okay, so let me see if I can extend this 10 feet. So my table will be all the way to beyond that, and it will go all the way to beyond my end of the pile. Okay, see here, 121. I can even go to, I can even to type 20 feet. It goes even beyond, so it's gonna go 20 feet beyond this. All right, so it went all the way 100. Now it's only 131 feet. All right. What else? By the way, let's come back to zero. We don't have some difference here due to the change of reference here that we have, because now everything is computed based on the latest reference we have. Now, what we're gonna do here, by the way, we have up to 5 reference to change here, okay? If we need to do more changes, what's gonna happen is, which has never happened, the only time we have seen more references, you know, one time the contractor was not following our specs, and he was putting a template attached to the barge, so that was, so we cannot prepare for that eventuality. In that case, either we tell the contractor to follow the specs, or another thing is, then the inspector is gonna have to, as soon as he runs out of five reference changes, he's gonna have to go back and start another log. In other words, you may have 2 or 3 logs, depending on how many times the reference changes, okay? That's why we really don't want to have those, you know, floating templates, because it's difficult to track. That's why, that is one of the reasons we don't want to have, and that's in the specs, we don't want to have variable elevation reference.